The oxidation of fatty acids. Fatty acids are an important source of energy for the body, and here we'll look at the reactions and processes that are involved in breaking down a fatty acid and getting simpler units. I've got an 8-carbon fatty acid. I've abbreviated its structure a little bit and didn't show you all the hydrogens. And actually, the hydrogens are a very important part of this structure because it's when the hydrogens go to the electron transport chain and combine with the oxygen that we breathe that gives us a lot of our ATP. Well, in this oxidation process, fatty acids, which are usually even numbered, are broken down 2 carbons at a time. And every one of those 2-carbon units produces acetyl-CoA. So we'd get a unit, another acetyl-CoA unit, another acetyl-CoA unit. And that's an overview of the oxidation process that occurs. Or another way of looking at it, we're starting here with a C8. After the first set of reactions, we'd be down to a C6, and we would have produced a molecule of acetyl-CoA. C6, as it goes to C4, would again give us another unit of acetyl-CoA. And now C4 only has to go through this process of reactions once to give us 2 units of acetyl-CoA. And this is called beta-oxidation. It occurs in the mitochondria. But before the fatty acid can get into the mitochondria, this carboxylic acid group has to be modified a little bit in what we call an activation step. Let's have a look at that. Here I've written out the structure now of the C8 fatty acid. I've put in the hydrogens, reacts with coenzyme A, and it's an energy requiring process. The energy comes from molecules of ATP. And in this process, ATP has 3 phosphate groups. 2 of those are cleaved off to give AMP and pyrophosphate. So a little later on, when we tabulate the energy that's available from the oxidation of a fatty acid, if we want to look at net energy, we'll remember to subtract the equivalent of 2 ATPs that were required in this initial step. Over here, the OH is gone. Now it's a coenzyme A derivative plus a water molecule. This fatty acyl-CoA can now permeate the mitochondrial membrane. Once it's inside, the beta oxidation process can take place. Sometimes we call that the fatty acid spiral. In that series of reactions, there are 4 key reactions that take place. And we don't expect that you memorize those reactions, but what's really important is to know the results. Let's have a look at that. The product of the first pass through the fatty acid spiral, or the beta oxidation process, is this molecule. It has 2 fewer carbons. When we started, we had a number 6 right there. Now we're down to 4. 2 of those carbons have been lumped off, and a molecule of acetyl-CoA has been produced. I mentioned that there are 4 reactions. In one of those reactions, a hydrogen molecule is pulled out, and it combines with FAD to form FADH2. This is an important energy-rich material because FADH2 can go to the electron transport chain, give up those 2 hydrogens, and produce ATP. Another reaction also gives off a hydrogen molecule, and it's taken on by NAD to form NADH and then a proton that's in solution, but the net equivalent of an H2 molecule. So these are the 3 energy-producing products of that first pass. Let's look at the second pass. We've got 2 fewer carbons again. We started with a C8, went to a C6, now we have a C4. And again, those 2 carbons that have been lumped off, I didn't write it here, but we've got another molecule of acetyl-CoA. And because we went through the series of 4 reactions, got another molecule of FADH2 and another molecule of NADH. Let's look at the third pass. Well, we went from a C8 to a C6 to a C4, and now as a C4 is broken apart, we're going to get 2 units of acetyl-CoA. We had to go through the series of 4 reactions to accomplish that. So we got another FADH2 and another NADH. Let's total all of these steps up now and see what we have. Here's a summary of the beta-oxidation process for that C8 carboxylic acid. We've got 8 carbons. That means that we could get 4 acetyl-CoA units because each one is carrying 2 carbons. Acetyl-CoA is the feedstock for the citric acid cycle. As it goes through that cycle and goes on to the electron transport chain, every acetyl-CoA can give rise to 10 ATPs. So if we've got 4 units of acetyl-CoA times 10, we're going to get a total of 40 ATPs from that part of the molecule. The hydrogens now, 3 molecules of FADH2. We had 4 acetyl-CoAs, but the last trip through the beta oxidation process gave us 2 units. That means that we had to go through that series of reactions only 3 times to accomplish that, even though we get 4 units. So 3 FADH2s, when they go to the electron transport chain, every FADH2 gives rise to 1.5 ATPs. 3 times 1.5, I didn't put that in, gives us 4.5 ATPs. And in that series of reactions, we'd get 3 NADHs. NADH, when it goes to the electron transport chain, gives us 2.5 ATPs. 3 times 2.5 would give us 7.5 total. If we add all of those numbers up now, the 3 numbers, we'd get 52 ATPs. Coming back to the activation step, where we use the equivalent of 2 ATPs to get something that can penetrate the mitochondrial membrane, we've got a net 50 ATPs. So this is an important skill for you to have. If we gave you a fatty acid and ask you, what's the net production of ATP from that fatty acid, we'd like you to be able to do that. So 3 key numbers that you need to memorize or have on your exam sheet, 10 ATPs for every unit of acetyl-CoA, 1.5 for FADH2, and 2.5 for NADH. Let's look at a typical problem. Okay. What if we ask you to calculate the net ATP from a 12-carbon fatty acid? Here are some considerations. Well, we want to find the units of acetyl-CoA. It's equal to the number of carbons divided by 2. So we're starting with 12 carbons, 12 divided by 2, we get 6 acetyl-CoA units. And the trips through the fatty acid spiral, or the beta oxidation pathway, the number of passes that we'd have to go through this series of 4 reactions, is 1 less than this number, carbons over 2 minus 1. Because, remember, in the last pass, we get 2 units of acetyl-CoA. So 6 units of acetyl-CoA times 10, 60. 5 FADHs times 1.5, 7.5 ATPs. 5 NADH2s times 2.5, 12.5 would get a total of 80 ATPs. And it took us 2 to get that sort of to prime the pump, I guess you could say. So the net is 78 ATPs. Be able to do something like that. There's a learning check in the text. There's another example in the text, also one in the tutor review, so that you can calculate the net ATP from a fatty acid.